Hey, what's happening, everybody? This is Robert, the Leather Cowboy Muhammad, down here in the dirty, just kick back chilling. I'm not kick back and chilling. I just got back from Tandy. Hey, went to the man cave, baby. That's the ultimate man store. If you're in this leather crafting business, and hey, I don't even get paid from Tandy to give them a shout out or give them a plug, but the store manager down there hit me up, gave me a call and said, hey, cowboy, look, we got some leather too. We got some tools and stamps that are being discontinued. You need to get down here and go through them and pick out some of these ones that you may not have. But once they're gone, they're gone. So I go down there, you know, and I was going anyway because I needed to pick up some other supplies. I need to pick up some more contact cement. I need to pick up some more antique gel, you know. I need to pick up some dyes, just like a couple of other knickknacks and things like that. But when he told me about the tools that are being discontinued, I was like, man, well, you know, I really did need that thumbprint pair shader. I did need some other tools and some backgrounding tools and bevelers. And he was like, look, we got some, and they're going, and once they're going, they're gone. They won't be able to get them back. So, jump in the truck, shoot down there, and sure enough, both of the thumbprint pair shaders that I wanted were there. Yes. Two different sizes, a medium and a small. This is going to really come in handy on doing the Sheridan artwork. And then this beveler that they had down there, this thing right here, man, I couldn't beat it for the price. And then this one here. Now, I have the oblong triangular piece, you know, where this part is the same on the opposite end. I have that one, and it does some great work. But I've been playing around with taking my other one. And y'all don't make me dig through that tool box. And I still haven't built my tool rack for a bit. Forgive me. But anyway, I've been playing around with just using the half part of the other tool that I got in the box. And did some work and it worked out fine. But I knew Tandy had this piece here. Went and it was in the discontinued box. So, hey, and then check this out. I'm going back Friday again and picking out some more because I put on stash, you know, don't tell Tandy, but I stashed back some other camouflage tools, some veiners that I needed because I've been watching a whole lot of Jim LaNail's videos. And man, that man can work some camouflage and veiner tools in this Sheridan artwork like nobody's business. And you guys, of course, know that I've been getting off into the Sheridan stuff. And that's really not my forte. I'm a stamper. But a lot of my clients are wanting that good old Western cowboy look type thing. So, hey, spent a lot of money. Went down. Shout out to Dee Dee. Great teacher. Look, if you guys are out there, check out her social media pages. It's under D&D Leatherwork or D&D Leathers. Awesome, awesome crafter, man. I mean, she's actually, I've been doing leatherwork a lot longer than she has, but this woman, I'm telling you, in the time that she's done it, she's really jumped in with both feet. And she's taking her leather craft work, man, is just, I mean, years of doing this business don't mean anything when you have somebody like her who has really took to it like a fish to water. And you can see her artwork, man, is not only a phenomenal artist, but an awesome crafter. And she's taking the time to teach good old cowboy some things. And actually, this is where Dee Dee has taken me to with my own crafting. With my own crafting. And this is just after two short classes of taking the time, pointing it out. So, hey, if you're in the southern area, down south, Alabama, Georgia, Tennessee, give Dee Dee a call, Dee Dee McGraw, D&D Leathers, and just look at some of her work, man. She is flawless. I actually tried to find some errors in her work. Can't find it. But anywho, Tandy. Tandy has an awesome discontinued sale right now. So if you guys are trying to up your tool box, up your tool racks, get down to Tandy Leather Factory. And like I said, I don't get paid for Tandy. I mean, Tandy don't even know me from a can of paint. But the simple fact of it is, Tandy has been good to me. Well, maybe it's just a Southern thing. And the Leather Factory here in Alabama, those guys have really looked out for me. Because, like I said, the GM didn't have to give me a call and say, hey, look, man, we got these two discontinued. Can you get here? See, he could have just put them out there for the mass market for somebody who really didn't know what they was doing. And they could have bought up all the tools. But, you know, hey, shout out to Matt. Appreciate you, Matt. But another thing is and even with the tools that I have now, and don't get me wrong, even with the tools that I just picked up and purchased, I'm going to really put these to work. Because like I said, if you're going to be doing the Sheridan design, you're really going to need those pair of shaders with the thumbprint. And Jim Linnell, like I said, Jim Linnell is doing several videos. If you want to get on there and learn how to do those, I'll probably do some of those videos my own after I've gone through them a time or two and really get a grasp on that. Because sometimes it's better to learn from people who just speak plain English. You know, it's not all technical. And you guys know, when you come on to the Cowboy page or the Cowboy YouTube page channel, you know, we're going to have some fun. I'm going to give it to you raw, uncut, but we're going to have some fun. And I'm going to show you how to save some money and how to make your work look great. Another key point real quick, and this is just an interjection because I'm working on these Gladiator sandals here. This is not antiqued at all. This is modified tools that I modified myself. That's a camouflage tool right there, and we use that in the foot portion as well, and some modified bevelers. And the reason why I'm gonna tell you this is this: some of Tandy's tools, like I said, I'm gonna keep it real with y'all now. Some of Tandy's bevelers are not angle steep enough, not on the lower end. Now, the Crafts Tools USA, they have got a little bit more incline and steepness in those tools for $18 a piece. But Tandy need to be ashamed of themselves, you know what I'm saying? But I'll tell you what I have done. And you can, especially on the bevel tools and some of the smooth pair shaders, if you guys can get Harbor Freight had a great awesome sale on belt sanders. You can get a 1-inch belt sander for like $49.99, or you can get a 4-inch belt sander for $54.99. I bought the 4-inch, and what I done, I took that 4-inch and I split it down the middle. That 4-inch sanding belt, split it down the middle, flip one side over so it's just the smooth side, not the grain side. Put it back onto the grinder, and then I took the sanding side. And I don't know if it's any sandpaper out there, especially for a belt sander, that's more than an 800 grit. Some of you hardware people, contractors might know that it is, and it probably is, but, or a finishing belt, when they get ready to sand floors and you want to finish it, you might can do that. But I don't know how that would transition with your tools. But I do know if you can get a hold of 1,000 grit wet sandpaper, that's perfect. And what I do, I take my beveler, and I'll angle it. I'll angle my table, my platform, where it's going to be at the degree that I want it. And then I would just put it right there, and then I'll file some of that down. I'll modify some of Tandy's tools just to give me a steeper. Let me let y'all see how steep that is. See, to me, this is not steep enough, especially when you're doing pieces to where you're going to be crossing over, or you're going to have multiple runs, like in the stalk of this Sheridan design here. See, I want to bevel that line, and then I want to come back and bevel this line. But if I use this tool, what it's going to do is it's going to push this part of the leather down that I don't want pushed down. I don't want it to lay down that much. If you see how wide that is, this is how much it's going to lay down when you start beveling down that thing. So we're going to pick this up just a little bit. I'll probably knock off probably about another one degree, maybe a 0.5. I just have to find out, play it by ear. But the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to mark my line with a Sharpie. And then I'm going to take it down to the Sharpie line. Tool a little bit with it. I'm not even worried about the smoothness at that point. I want to make sure there's going to be the right depth and steepness to where I can really get in there and tool. That's the big advantage a lot of these other tool makers have, like your Barry Kings or even some of your Al Starman. Jim Linnell's son now is starting to do tools. And that's the advantage that they have over Tandy. Tandy is not doing the steep enough tool on that level. I mean, they are doing some, but you really gotta come with that paper. You know, maybe one of these days I'll do a video on how to modify some of your tools to where you don't have to spend that $18. You can spend that same $6 and get the same result out of those tools. But hey, look, just to let y'all guys know again, get down to Tandy, man. They have a great discount, discontinued sale going on right now. I think it should be at all of them because they sent out the same tools to all of the stores. So, but go in, ask the manager, hey, where are those discontinued tools that y'all are getting rid of? Tandy's getting rid of them. They're not going to make them anymore. They might even have some 3D stamps. I think I saw like 3 or 4 3D stamps, but it was that Boy Scout looking stuff. Now, I don't do Boy Scout work, you know, but hey, look, if that's what you want to get into, you know, hey, do you. But get down to Tandy, man, and go through there and look at their stuff, and you can, it's like the Christmas sale in July because they discontinuing it. And build a good relationship with the GM or the AGM at Tandy. So, hey, when they do stuff like this, they'll give you a call and be like, hey, look, you need to get down here and check out some of these tools, man, before they get gone. Because once they're gone, they're gone. Hey, this is the Leather Cowboy right here, Premier Leather Crafters, down south in the Dirty Dirty. Thank y'all for chilling with me these 12 and a half minutes. And, hey, like always, see y'all on the other side.